In this video, we will simulate the voltage drop across a trace that we import from KiCad. Let's open KiCad, create the project, and open the schematic editor. Add a component by pressing A on the keyboard. Create two connectors. Now connect them. And double click on them to open the property editor. Select the footprint. Copy this footprint to the other connector. Annotate the schematic. Annotation simply means to assign a number to all components. Switch to the PCB editor. Import the schematic data and place the component around the zero position of the PCB editor. Create a rectangle and type E while it is still marked to open the property editor. Set the same start and end points as me. And change the layer to Edge Cuts. Edge Cuts is simply the name of KiCad for the board outline. I will move the two pads into the corners of the PCB, flip one of them to the bottom of the PCB, connect the two pads, open FreeCAD, and copy this text into the Python console of FreeCAD. Mark the copper layer and export it as a step file by typing Ctrl plus E on the keyboard. Now open Gmsh and open the step file. Expand the mesh tree and click 1D, 2D, 3D. Refine the mesh 2 times to make it finer. Now click on Save. This will automatically generate the mesh file. Now open Elmer and load the mesh file. Create a new equation and set it up as I did. Check out this video on how to enable the Static Current tab. Now set the material to copper. We want to inject into this surface. Double click on it and the corresponding number should be marked in the boundary summary. Add a boundary condition. Mark the surface and set it to a potential of 10 millivolts. I will simply call this boundary 10 millivolts. Now mark the opposite side. And remember the number of the boundary. Set this one to 0 volts. Click on Run and save the project. Once the simulation is finished, open Elmer VTK, click on the surface, and select Potential. The lower limit should be close to 0 and the upper limit close to 10 millivolts. If that's not the case, most of the times you can solve this issue by making the mesh finer. Now select the vector view and change the view to volume current.